the Son. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Our God is three in one. I believe in the resurrection, that we will rise again. For I believe in the name of Jesus.
Let me get to just the, I'll get to the next chorus.
Welcome you to Bethany Church today. I do have just a few announcements before we begin. And how many really enjoyed our missionary last week? Give him a big hand, all right? All right. Through the offerings that were given, our change offering was over $400. And then the other offerings that came in at the baskets was around, a little over $300. So over 700, plus I think there's still a couple of unaccounted checks. And if you haven't donated to the Good Family and are interested in doing that, you can take one of the envelopes in the pew, fill that out, and put on their goods, and that offering will go to the goods. This morning, we have several announcements that... Let me grab these. They're all over the place. Blue note, be sure and fill that out so we have a record of you being here. There's a little flyer like this called the Easter Egg Hunt. On the back side is our Agape Feast. The Agape Feast is on Monday, Thursday. This one's important because it tells you it's a potluck dinner, but we're going to eat things that were what they would have eaten in the first century, and so you have to make it according to what's there. There's instructions on that. There's also a postcard in the bulletin. And that postcard is what we want to send out to people in the community. But we need names and addresses of your friends. You can either fill that out and drop it in the offering plate, and we'll make sure it gets mailed to somebody you know to invite them to come. Or you can just call into the office and give us the name and address, and we will make sure that they get an invitation from the church. Now, a little more personal is we have some little pocket invitations. And it says, I want to invite you to come and see the difference Good Friday and Easter can make. Join us. And it just, that's all it says. And you can leave this with your tip at the restaurant today, all right? Just make sure you tip them really well, all right? We don't want them to think that we're stingy around here, all right? And so those are some of the announcements we have. We also have a Bethany moment today. Is Ida McCutcheon here somewhere? All right. Ida, are you here? We need Ida to come up. Go ahead. You can start this. Some of you aren't aware, but Ida is one of the bravest people. Come on down. Ida, come on down. She's one of the bravest people we have in the church. Look at here. This is Ida.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, this is Ida. Oh, your hair's a little messed up.
Yeah. There you go.
Can you believe this? Oh, my, my. Is this great? This is a Bethany moment. I mean, look at here. Perfect landing. Oh, come on. Let's give it up for Ida.
I know. Oh, my gosh. That was so much fun. I have to contribute that landing to the guy that took me. His name was Star Cruz. He was from, anyway, out of the country. And he happened at one time to be a captain of a ship. He's gone into this now, and he did a beautiful job of helping me down, talk to me all the way. And thank you. And there was another reason for doing it. As you know, many of you contributed to the bill when my daughter died, and so my grandson released her ashes as a part of it. So there was another reason for doing it.
Wow.
I was motivated, shall we say.
Oh, Lord bless you. I have a Bethany pin for you.
Thank you.
So for such a moment like that, God bless you. Yeah. The Bible says God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and a sound mind. I don't know, jumping out of an airplane, a perfectly good airplane, is necessarily a sound mind, but Ida, we appreciate you. That was wonderful. That was spectacular. I have another Bethany pen I want to give out today. Where is Bob Caldrone? I want Bob to come. Come on up, Bob. Bob, come on up. And David and Heidi, I want them to come up. And Bob has filled in for us while we have not had a worship leader. And he's done fabulous. And I think he deserves a hand. And we won't be pushing you out of airplanes or anything, but...
he flies airplanes.
Oh, he's a pilot. Oh, anybody else like to jump?
The thing we say is, why would anyone ever jump out of a perfectly good flying airplane?
Yeah. David has agreed to be our worship leader, and he's come on to our staff. It's a part-time position, but his whole heart is into that. And we want to start off by giving you a Bethany pen.
Thank you.
And Heidi, you've been so supportive. God bless you. God bless you. All right.
I'll make it a 2-for-1-minute announcement and probably do it in 30 seconds. The Camp Lael Comedy Club fundraiser is coming up. It's Tuesday, April 11th. It's always a good time. Camp Lael makes a lot of money. The comedy's clean. Everybody has a great time. That's Mark Ridley's in Royal Oak. Tuesday, April 11th, $25 are tickets. You can buy them from me or you can buy them at the door. Second one is, it's spring cleanup time. Is this working?
Yep.
And a lot of people do a lot of work outside in the yard. I don't. I don't like that stuff. But if you're going to do that stuff, think ahead. Buy Scrip. We make a lot of money from Home Depot, Lowe's, Bordines. We make lots of money off of those. So if you have big projects you're planning, plan ahead, buy Scrip, talk to Amy. It'd be great for you and great for us. Thanks.
All right. And then there's a lot of things going on. Today is a spectacular Sunday, and a lot of people brought some spuds in to go in the baskets or the bags that we're going to be distributing here on Saturday. Two things about that. We're going to fill the bags this afternoon right after the service. The second thing is on Saturday, there's an Easter egg hunt here. And after the Easter egg hunt, at noon, there is going to be distribution of those food bags for the open door to people in in the community who are in need. We need a few more volunteers. We have four so far signed up. We could use a lot more help on that. And then again, one more other item. Next Sunday is Palm Sunday. And so we want you to be here for Palm Sunday. That kicks off Holy Week. Thursday's Maundy Thursday. On Friday is Good Friday service. And then on Easter Sunday, a great time to invite someone to join with you and come to Bethany Church. We have a special treat. Some of us have supported Connie as she went on a missions trip to Mexico. And Connie is going to share a little bit about that trip.
Okay, so over my spring break, I went to Juarez, Mexico. There was 54 of us total. So here's a picture of us. There was students from Michigan Tech, Northern, Ferris State, and Saginaw Valley. There was 9 of us from Saginaw Valley. This is the best picture, but that's us. So we went to Juarez. We drove to Mexico. It was a 36-hour drive. We left on Friday around 5, and we did not get to Mexico until Monday morning. We stopped in New Mexico, and then we stayed the night in El Paso, Texas. So once we got to Juarez, Mexico, we stayed in this compound here on cots. And so Monday when we got there, it was like 8 o'clock, I think. So we unloaded the vans of all of our luggage. Within an hour, we loaded them back up with our tools and everything, and we were on the work sites and building our house. So when we got there, this is what it looked like. Just our materials and then nothing really there. And then we started, as soon as we got there, building the base. And we started nailing the wood together and then the cement poured. And so by the end of day one, we had a cement slab, which would be the base of our house. And then, so that was all morning. And then in the afternoon, we started constructing the walls. And so at the end of day one, we had our cement base, and then you can see that the walls, we piled up, and that was the end of day one. So then, that's me measuring some wood for these walls. So then on day two, we put the walls up, and we did a blackboard, and we did chicken wire, and insulation, and the roof, and we just, by the end of day two, we actually started to see a house. And then on day three, we did stucco. So that's me with some stucco. Stucco is made out of sand, water, and lime, and we sit together. And we so that's the outside of the house. And while we were doing that on the outside, they were doing drywall on the inside. And so, so it was a three-roomed house. So this is on the inside, or you're on the outside looking in, and there's one long room and there's two rooms. And the house had electricity, and as you can see, a ceiling fan. It's just another picture. And then that's the house. So there was dogs everywhere in Mexico, and we were told not to touch them, assume they had diseases. But that one, actually, very dirty. And so this is the finished product of the house. So, yeah.
I apologize for having the same hat on 3 times. Kind of hard to find variety in Easter headwear, though. As you probably know, I'm here to remind you about the Easter egg hunt. It's coming this Saturday, 10 o'clock. What we'd like you to do is bring kids. They're going to have a wonderful time, and I can guarantee you they'll find it a rewarding, enlightening time. We could also use a couple more people to help, and if you think you could put a couple hours in on Saturday morning, see Kathy. And we'll see you all Saturday.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I hope we're ready to worship this morning. You know, worship is an activity. It's not something that you receive. It's something that you give to the Lord out of joy, out of thankfulness, out of gladness for all of the favor, for all of the mercy that He bestows on us each and every day. Feel good, you want to sing about it. And I hope you're in that mood today, because singing, worship, that brings the Lord's Spirit into us. And we want you to feel that today as you as we get together and praise and worship. So please stand and join with me in singing and worshiping God. Thank you.
Jesus, Messiah, Lord of all, we come in your name today to ask for your presence to be among us, for you have said, where two or three are gathered in your name, there you are also. May we sense the presence of the true and living God. As we lift up our voice in worship and praise, may you be magnified. Lord, some of us have come in troubled. Our spirits are downcast, and the songs have lifted our hearts. We pray, Lord, as we continue to sing, that your presence would make us feel reassured of your love, of your mercy, your grace, and your peace. We pray, Father, that out of that love, we would be able to give back to you a gift, our offering to say, Lord, we love you back because you loved us so much. So bless our offerings, O Lord. Utilize them to accomplish your great purpose. Bring glory to your great name, for we've come to worship you as the Lord Most High. Bless us now in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you.
side.